Most of the analysis of the ECB's expanded asset purchase program has naturally focused on its effects inside the euro area. But the program also had a considerable impact outside the euro area. We examined the imprint of the program on international bond and deposit flows by combining information from several different data sources, including the BIS International Banking Statistics. More concretely, we looked into who are the main foreign sellers of euro area government bonds during the program, how did they execute the sales, and what did they do with the proceeds. Institutional investors, primarily located in the United Kingdom, were the main foreign sellers of euro area bonds during the program. Since those investors could not directly engage with the euro area central bank buying the bonds, they had to go through a commercial bank located outside the euro area and its affiliate inside the euro area. Here's how it worked. The central bank buying the bond credited the account of the bank inside of the euro area, which in turn credited the account of its affiliate outside the euro area, which ultimately credited the account of the institutional investor selling the bond. Our findings suggest that, somewhat surprisingly, foreign institutional investors kept a large chunk of the proceeds, or about one-fifth, in the form of euro-denominated deposits in banks located outside the euro area. The BIS banking statistics reveal that banks located in the United Kingdom were the main recipients of euro-denominated deposits. Thus, it appears that banks in the United Kingdom were the main facilitators of the bond sales during the program. Our findings highlight the role of the United Kingdom as a financial gateway into the euro area.